to hear that loud boom or feel a shake at your house yesterday, many of you called us, you emailed us, Facebooked us, as well as tweeted us. It's actually called a frost quake. WISN 12 meteorologist Chris Gloninger joins us live to tell us what causes this.
And Toy, in the seismology world, it's called a cryoseism. And you can actually see this glass bottle right here. And I have it filled with water, and it's a part of a demonstration that you'll see after this report. We're going to try to recreate it. Now, with a cryoseism or a frost quake, it's what happens below the ground that causes that jolt or that boom. In 3, 2, 1. Think of this as a cryoseism in a bottle or a frost quake.
You have all this water in the soil, and because the temperatures drop so low, the amount of freezing goes deeper into the earth, you know, by, we're talking feet here.
University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee seismologist Brett Ketter explains that this moist soil freezes, expands, and when that happens, you hear a pop. To demonstrate a frost quake, we took this glass bottle, filled it with water. Since it's plenty cold outside, we're going to wait for it to freeze. And when it does, this bottle will crack. And that's exactly what goes on below ground during a frost quake. The water expands as it freezes.
There's not a lot known about them because they're so infrequent. And because they're so localized, you're usually dealing with a what's called a felt report. Somebody calls in and says, hey, this happened.
After your calls, emails, tweets, and Facebook messages, we checked the seismograph, but there was nothing.
You'd almost need a recording device right underneath it to get it because they're so small and localized.
The freezing process makes other noises. If you've ever been ice fishing, you've probably heard this. That's also caused by ice moving, expanding, and contracting. It's amazing the science when it gets this cold and temperatures are in the double digits below zero. We're almost at this process. You saw in the story, the cap pops off first. I'm going to hasten the process and actually pour out the water to prevent an explosion. You can see right now there's some liquid in there, but you'll also notice, if you look closely, that there's a thin layer of ice around the perimeter, the internal perimeter of this bottle. So it's well on its way, and probably another 10 minutes or so, this would have shattered like the bottle that you saw in the story. With the thaw coming up and temperatures going back down, that roller coaster continues. Don't be surprised if you feel another jolt or hear another boom in the next couple of weeks. For now, reporting live in Milwaukee, meteorologist Chris Gloninger, WISN 12 News.